Led by Charles Osendro, the spokesperson of Lango traditional leaders, they said that in Lango it is very important for the two clans to reconcile before the burial of the minister Ingola. According to him, 7 cows must be sacrificed, followed by other rituals, and this is achieved after a meeting and agreement.
That do handle that when it comes to the time of compensation, handling that part. But that is why the Lao as a tribe is asking the relatives or the tribe of the killer, Sabiti, to come out willingly and meet Lao.
Relatedly, the Otikochin, the clan to which the retired Colonel Charles Okello Engola belonged, has come up with 5 demands they want the government to fulfill before their son is laid to rest. During an open meeting at Lango Culture Center, Christopher Oleke, the deputy clan leader of Otikochin, revealed that they want a clear report on the death of the minister Ingola, blood compensation as per the culture of Lango, a clear commitment to implement projects started by Okello, and a clear commitment by the government on the compensation for the murder.
We were told is that the different government security agencies had set in motion investigations. And as a clan where late Charles Okello Engola hails from, we await a clear report from the investigations which will tell us the circumstances under which our son was gunned down.
Blood compensation is a must. The Toro should pay and give us at least something that will bring peace. It is just bringing peace between the Toro and then the Lango culture.
Robert James Ajal, the Prime Minister of Lango Culture Foundation, observes that minister should be succeeded by his son in parliament, as it has been happening in other places. He also demands that Minister Engola is promoted to the rank of brigadier.
Yes, that Colonel Engola was handling should be handled either by government or a foundation. Put a foundation either through parliament to handle some of these projects. We also think we should consider a possibility of maybe, since he was a representative, maybe to be represented, to be replaced by his son in parliament. The other one is that we implore government to do proper investigation and get us, if it was easy, we should get information before the burial.
However, Crispus Ayena Odong, the former lawyer of LRA Commander Dominique Ongwen, noted that the cultural institution has no right to dictate to the people of Oyam North who to vote for.
I treat this occurrence of the death of my brother as a very serious thing. We should properly mourn him, bury him, and then we discuss the issue of his succession. First of all, I do not believe that the Council of Wanyashe has the mandate to choose a member of parliament or even to propose who should be a member of parliament.
Just like any other person, Ayena finds it very difficult to believe that Engola was killed by his bodyguard. He says the matter should be properly investigated.
Uganda should wake up and critically analyze the circumstances under which my brother died. A man who was happily with the same bodyguard alleged to have been his assassin were in Namutumba the previous day. Less than 12 hours later, the same man shoots him. If there was bitterness, it should have manifested the previous day. Because
Minister Charles Engola will be laid to rest on Saturday the 13th of May at his ancestral home in Awanji, Aicheme Sub-County, Oyam District. Report compiled by Doreen Nasima and Hudson Apunyu for the news.